Welcome to this Liverpool Fan TV. This is full time reaction for our game against Leicester, and I will talk about rest of result of the weekend. I know it's a bit late, but we had a festival in India and there was family reunion, so didn't get time to do that. I managed to watch the match somehow, and it was nerve wracking at the end, and we got the deserving penalty. There is a talk that it is not a penalty. In my eye, it is a penalty, and maybe if it was gone against it, I would have called it soft, but it is a penalty. And I read one line, Brendan Rodgers said that he deserved something out of the game, they did not deserve to lose or something like that. I get that because it was last minute penalty, but we had lot of chances to score lot. Few more, Milner in the first half scooped just over the bar. Firmino miskicked that great ball from Trent. Mane, from just after scoring a goal from Firmino, he should have made it 2-0. Salah in the second half, even Van Dijk header, and few more chances. And if we score a couple of them, it is a totally different game. And Brendan, I know he's a keen observer and he makes a lot of notes, and he knew that he only had two attempts, his team only had two attempts, one on target and that goes into goal, and it was Adrian's fault too. Adrian should have saved that, and if Adrian makes that save, no one talks about that they deserve something out of the game. It's not that Leicester play was threatening and something like that. We completely annihilated them in the first half, and I thought 1-0 was not fair reflection of the half. We totally dominated them, and as I said, that we had lot many chances. I thought Mane and Milner were superb, and ball from Milner was excellent. Any other player does that, they will be lauded and raved all week, but I don't see anyone making anything big out of that, and I was disappointed because that ball was excellent. And before that, the playing out from the back was superb. Mane finish was excellent. So all in all, it was superb goal, and I think that should win goal of the month for this month. Even though we will, it's still early days in this month, but I think it's contender for that because the way it was played out the back and ball from Milner was excellent and probably one of the ball of the season. I don't see that. I don't think it is getting right praise or deserved praise, to be honest. And man of the match performance from Milner, and Lovren was excellent too. And for me, I think it was best Lovren performance in Liverpool shirt. I don't recollect anything like that from him in a long time. Maybe one or two game, but that, as I said, I do not recollect right now. I think it is his best game. He was excellent. Interception was excellent, and whenever he needed defensive cover on the wide areas, he did that, and in the aerial duels as well. So the three players stand out from that game, but I'll go with Milner. Penalty man with steel balls, to be honest. You know that if you miss that, we will lose our 100% winning rate in a Premier League and all those stuff. Lot much thing riding on it, but he took him on himself and he did wonderful job. So big up, and I think he was man of the match for me. I don't know who got it. Probably Mane would have got it, but I think Milner deserved that. Now all the result from the weekend: Brighton versus Tottenham. Brighton 3, Tottenham 0. That was poor from Tottenham. I do not want to take anything away from Brighton, to be honest. They scored beautiful goals, and from since Graham Potter is their manager, they are doing bits in, they are playing attackingly. But first goal was down to Lloris, and he injured himself, so speedy recovery for him, but it was mistake from him. And defensively, Tottenham looked open entire game. I don't know what happened to them. Probably the three key players on the last year of contract is hampering them. But whatever, As I said, I'm not taking anything away from Brighton. That's a massive victory. I wouldn't have predicted that. So one wrong, one prediction. Even though I did not do preview, but I will be honest with the judgment of the result. Norwich 1, Aston Villa 5. Norwich were abject. I know they are lacking quite a few first team players due to injury, but that was poor from them, and that could be that result could be detrimental in their Premier League survival, to be honest. And big win for Aston Villa, which they were looking for quite some time. So I wouldn't have got that right, to be honest. I would have predicted Norwich or even draw. So that thing I got it wrong. Watford, Sheffield United, that was poor game. Watford had a good chance. I think Gray has chance to put that in. I think Pereira won the ball and he did everything right. It was just a little bit behind from Andre Gray, but he missed an open goal. So other than that, there was a couple of chances for Watford again. Even though the game was not great, but Watford had chance to win it, which they failed to win. And Sheffield United is still unbeaten on away turf, which is a big up for them. Especially promoted team always lack away points, so it's a big thing for Sheffield United. I would have predicted Watford win, even though I know they haven't won yet, but I would have predicted. So first three I would have got it wrong. Burnley 1, Everton 0. I would have predicted Burnley win because Everton are sick. Right now sick, traveling away from home, and they have lost 4 in 4, something like, even though against Manchester City they deserve something out of the game. They did not score in the opportunity they had, and Manchester City were clinical that day and they lost, but still Everton were struggling away from home. So I would have predicted Burnley, and it's a big result from Burnley. And now Burnley are back. After last season, the Europa disaster, now they are looking like Burnley side of a couple of years back, and they are performing good. Leipzig 2, Leicester 1. I would have predicted 2-1, to be honest, or 3-1. I would have gone for 3-1, but thankfully we won. West Ham 1, Crystal Palace 2. I wouldn't have predicted that. West Ham, I don't know what happened to them. They had chances to draw or even win that game, but they did not took, and Crystal Palace were clinical and they won the game 2-1. Southampton 1, Chelsea 4. Chelsea are doing bits in Lampard regime, to be honest, and I thought they will struggle. I don't know, I have mentioned this or not, or maybe probably mentioned it quite a few times, that I thought that they will struggle because of transfer ban and new manager. But they are not showing any sign of it. And Lampard, in 3 months' time, has implemented what's the way he wants to play. And he has given a chance to English players, and they are repaying his faith. And Mason Mount is a baller, and I really like him. And I think he will be a player to look forward, to be honest, for the future. And if you manage to nick him away from Chelsea, it would be great, but he just signed 5-year contract, so I think he will stay there. And luckily for young players that there is a transfer ban. If transfer ban is not there, I don't think Tammy Abraham or Mason Mount gets the chance, or even Lampard gets the chance at Chelsea. That's a big result, and Southampton were poor that day. Even though Danny Ings got a goal back on 2-1 and should have made 3-2 because he was through on goal. But still, Chelsea deserve their win. Arsenal 1, Bournemouth 0. I would have predicted that victory. To be honest, I saw a lot of Arsenal fan complaining about their performance in the second half. But you need to remember, Arsenal fans, that you were playing in, on Thursday, and then I see all the team who plays on Thursday and then Sunday, they always struggle, and they need to think over that result is most important when you're playing Thursday, Sunday, because most of the team will struggle when they play in Europa. So they should back Emery he got the job done, and there were chances in the game to make it more emphatic win, and probably a penalty against Pepe. So even though that performance was not good, as per Arsenal fan, I see that they should have won at least 2-0, or maybe one Callum Wilson chance was Arsenal. It was open goal, so you can say that 3-1 should have been fair result, and maybe that would have pleased Arsenal fan. But you need to remember, Arsenal fans, that it's not easy to play Thursday, Sunday. So if your team is winning on Sunday, you should be happy about it. Manchester City nailed Wolves to another team who played on Thursday and won on Sunday. So they are breaking the jinx of Thursday, Sunday, to be honest. And even though Manchester City had a chance to score and go ahead, but I think Wolves also had a chance. Jimenez and one more guy, I forgot his name, I think Doherty, was through on goal, and they should have done better. But in the second half, Traore was superb and two couple quick goals in 80th minute and 93 minute, I think. Both very well taken, which everyone say that Traore does not have in him the clinical edge. But he did that, and probably he's improving under Nuno. And Nuno would be static, he said. I think against Crystal Palace, the late leveler against Crystal Palace, he said that this is my turning point. And honestly, he did that, and three win in three now. And they are back, totally back. The last game on Sunday, Newcastle, Manchester. I wouldn't have got that. So right now, I think 5 or 6 result, I wouldn't see that come. I did not see that coming. The last one, 2, Newcastle 1, Manchester United 0. I did not see that coming because Newcastle were very poor against Leicester, 5-0. I know they were 10 men down, but still, they were very, very poor. And I thought Manchester United were poor too. And against West Ham and against Arsenal too, that game itself was very poor. I did watch along, and it did not fancy watching that again. That was poor game. So I thought they need some kind of a fight back, and which Solskjaer didn't get. And Newcastle deservingly win 1-0. Maybe if Harry Maguire would have scored, it could have been different game. But same could be said that if that kid who finally scored, Matty Longstaff, if his shot did not hit the crossbar and goes in, it could have been different game too. So no if and buts. Manchester United were poor, and Newcastle were deserving winner. The only thing now worries me is that whenever Manchester United Liverpool game is like a derby, no doubt about that. So whenever team is struggling, you don't want to play against them. That when you are thinking of they need to react, it's a difficult time to play against them. But whatever we have to face, we will face in a couple of weeks time. But right now, need to praise Matty Longstaff. His interview was excellent. I really liked it. He could not stop his smile and laugh, and both brother were very happy. So very happy about that. And a Newcastle fan themselves had a very poor, torrid time. So if one of academy players scores and you win, it gives you added bonus. So very happy for them too. They had very difficult time since Rafa left. And Steve Bruce was also under pressure, so he will be relieved, man. And I think after 22 times of try, now we have finally won against Manchester United. So big monkey off his back too. So that's all about all the results. Probably on Friday, as there is a no game, I will talk about a few individuals like Klopp, who just completed 4 years with us. So we will reflect on his time with us. Mane, who scored 50th goal on 100 appearance in Premier League, and Adrian, even though he did made couple of errors, I think, but he had been very good, and I think he is I think best second choice goalkeeper in Premier League. Or in other words, Alisson of second choice of goalkeeper in a Premier League. I will talk about him on Friday night. I will be live, and I'll be talking about these three and probably one or two Other member of our team, probably Trent and Robert too, but these three I'll prepare and I'll talk about if I'll get time, I'll talk about others too. Thanks guys, thanks for watching. Bye bye.